Hi, in this video we're going to talk about compounding continuously. And I've jumped over to the next page so that we can look at the formula before we do the calculation. So I want to explain what compounding continuously means, and then I also found a great web page and I'll show you that also. So as we were talking about compounding in the last video, we saw that what we were doing is changing this number of compounding periods, right? That number was getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Think of that's divided by 1, and then 4, 12, 365. Compounding continuously is what happens if you let this number go to infinity. You're saying we're going to compound this money every second of every day, every moment. It's continuously compounding. It's always compounding every second, every nanosecond. So we're essentially letting this number go to infinity. Now we have to use a different formula because we can't divide a number by infinity. Excel will not like that. So what this does is as you let this number approach infinity, it becomes a different function or different formula. Now this is the formula. And it uses an exponential function. If you've learned in algebra about the base of e, this is the principal times e to the rt. Okay, now let me show you what this looks like in a graph before we go on with how to do that. I have found a great website and I'll put the link in the description. It's betterexplained.com. And I thought it'd be great to show you a graph so you can see what's going on here. This simple interest trajectory shows, just like in our example, we were getting the same amount every single year. So that's a linear pattern because it just goes up the same exact amount every year. Okay, I'm going to scroll down a little bit. When you're compounding, you get a little extra, right? You don't get the same amount every year. You get extra each year. So it starts to go up a little bit faster. And we saw that, how we got more money. Now, the more times you compound, the faster it's gonna go up, right? It's gonna start to curve up faster. I keep going. Yeah, so here you can see how it's starting to go up faster and faster and faster. I'm gonna skip the interest gap and that one. Okay, here we are, continuous growth. So if we went up faster and faster and faster, see how there's these little gaps? I think that's what they were talking about. These gaps essentially will go away because you're now compounding at every single moment. And these, if you compound more and more and more often, it will approach this curve, which is called the exponential function. And its base is e, which is an irrational number. It's a little bit over 3. And we raise it to whatever power is in our formula. Okay, so let me see. Yes, here's the value for e, 2.718. It goes on and on. It is an irrational number. Here's our formula, p times e to the rt. I always remember it by pert, p-e-r-t. Okay, so let's go back to our formula, which is the same one. PE to the RT. Okay, now we could do this in a calculator. I'm going to do it in Excel or in a spreadsheet. So let's go back. Here's our formula. Let's go back to our last page. And I'm going to write the formula down here at the bottom so we can see it. It's going to be, in spreadsheet terms, P times EXP. That's the function, just like FV and PV are functions. And its inputs are the rate and, oh sorry, it's not an and. Let me fix that real quick. It's not an and, it's a times. It has a single input, which is the rate times the number of years. Yes, we don't have compounding periods because we're compounding continuously all the time. Okay, so what would this look like in our example? We are putting in $500. Remember, we have to put in the asterisk for times. EXP, exponential function. Our rate is 0.06, and it is times 5 years. Okay, now this should have a bigger number, right? We should get more money by compounding more often. Let me go back. Okay, I'm using a completely different function this time, so I'm just going to go to a different cell. Scoot this over. I'm just going to click down here, go to a different cell. Equals 500 times EXP, and you can notice it's giving some possible functions that I might want to use here. When I open it, it shows me, it verifies that is a function that the spreadsheet has, and its input is the exponent, so it was e to the power, right? So our exponent is 0.06 times 5. It's RT. Close it up. Hit enter. 674.93. I wanted to write it over here just so we can compare more easily. 91.93. You can see we're only getting 2 more cents, but it is more. So the reason it's going up less and less and less, let's go back to the graph. The less you compound, the flatter it will be. And then the more you start compounding, the faster and faster and faster it will get up. But you don't gain quite as much by increasing the compounding rate. However, you still get more money. So definitely better to go from, you know, simple to yearly and then yearly to quarterly. But it's also great to go from, you know, yearly to daily. Okay, so that is compounding continuously, and I'll see you in the next video.